We're looking at a beautiful 2008 Toyota RAV4. It's the model with a 3.5-liter V6 engine, the 2GR-FE. And just a few days ago, this car came very close to suffering an irreparable and permanent catastrophic engine loss. I'm gonna tell you how we fixed it and how we prevent the recurrence of this problem. This car was brought to us about 10 days ago for a pre-purchase inspection by one of our customers. We looked at the car and we determined that everything was in very good shape, but we did advise the customer of one thing, that the variable valve timing oil line, which runs along the side of the engine, variable valve timing oil line, which is on the rear bank, also known as bank one, or the right hand bank, when it runs from the top front of this bank along the side to the rear, and this allows the operation of the variable valve timing. Well, we advised the customer that this line had not undergone the recommended service by Toyota of replacing the rubber oil line with an all-metal oil line. And we advised them that they should have this service performed as soon as possible because of the danger of catastrophic oil loss and permanent damage to the engine. Okay. So they went ahead and purchased the car, and the soonest that we could get them into our shop was the following week. They made their purchase on a Thursday, and on Sunday, the owner of the car, our customer, called us and said, "Hey, I'm driving down the highway, and there's an oil smell coming from the car, and when I slowed down, there's smoke that's coming out from under the hood. What should I do?" I said, "Stop right where you are, shut the engine off, keep it shut off, do not restart the car under any circumstance, and wait for our tow truck to arrive." So I sent a tow truck out to pick up the car, and I'm going to show you what we found. First of all, we found that the entire side of the engine on this side was covered in oil, and there was oil dripping down the back and the side of the engine. Then we inspected the oil line, and I'll show you the oil line that we removed from the car. But first, we checked the oil, and we found that the oil was 2 quarts low. When we checked the engine as part of our pre-purchase inspection, the oil level was full with clean oil. This is the VVTi, or variable valve timing oil line. Right here is the banjo connector that attaches to the front of the rear bank. And right here is the banjo that goes in to the rear. And of course, these have banjo bolts and washers to hold them. But right here is the crucial part, this rubber part. Okay. And what we found in this particular instance was that right here at this joint is where it had just suddenly started to leak out and spurt out oil. And this oil is under pressure, so once it starts leaking, it's like a water fountain. It just spurts right out. And the engine lost a couple of quarts of oil within just a few minutes probably. And if our customer had not been alert, they would have lost all of their oil and seized their engine. Now I'm going to show you one of the possible replacement parts. Okay, this one is just slightly different because it comes from a different engine. It comes from a Lotus engine, also a 3.5 liter V6, and it's shaped a little bit differently to allow for the supercharger pulleys. Now the part that you would buy from Toyota and that we put back into the RAV4 is the exact same shape as this rubber oil line, as this original oil line. It's the same shape, but as with this Lotus oil line, which is all metal from end to end, the replacement Toyota part is all metal, including this elbow right here. So there is no possibility of a failure that results in a catastrophic oil leak. Okay, so we put this back in the engine and tested it for any oil leaks. Everything was fine, and we put it back on the road, and we have another satisfied customer.